jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long.
What's up guys, it's Josh, we're back again with another video. I already made a video on why I chose to do Air Force ROTC at Yale, but today I'm going to talk about what exactly the life of an ROTC cadet entails. Let's get into it. In most cases, ROTC is a four-year program. You can join in like during your sophomore year, but most people experience a program for all 4 years. This means the detachment is split into four main groups. AS-100s are freshmen, 200s sophomores, 300s juniors, 400s seniors. I'm currently an AS-100 as I am a first year at Yale. I don't really feel like I'm qualified yet to speak on what it's like being a higher ranked cadet in the program, but I will share with you guys what my experience as a AS-100 has been. All right, there are three main components to my ROTC life at Yale. Those are PT, which is physical training, leadership lab, and then class. At Yale, we have PT twice a week. Currently, it is on Tuesday and Thursday mornings. It starts at 6 and goes till 7, but of course, you gotta be there at 5:45, because if you're not early, you're late. It is a little bit of a rough wake up, but I think I've finally gotten used to it. Like most elements of ROTC, PT is cadet run. We have a PT commander that comes up with the workouts for each week, and also leads us through each part of PT, whether that be warm up, stretching, the actual workout, or the cool down. Most of the time, we like to mix it up at PT, but no matter what the day, you can guarantee that you're going to be doing a lot of running, a lot of push-ups, and a lot of core, like sit-up type stuff. Those are the three main components of our fitness test that we have to do each semester. An example workout might be a 25 minute Indian run up on the track, and then we'll come down and do like a 20 minute high intensity interval training circuit that might involve some ab workout too. We also have our own special PT flights where cadets either choose to be in the cardio, the agility, or the bulking flight. So you can kind of set your own PT goals and develop how you want to. We don't split into these groups every time, but a couple times a month you can guarantee on being split into your groups and where you're able to work on what you want to work on, which is kind of nice. Overall, I enjoy PT a lot. It is never easy waking up that early, but you always break a sweat and get a good workout in, so it's worth it in the end. All right, the next component of ROTC is Leadership Lab, which takes place immediately after PT on Thursdays. As soon as we're done with PT, we run up to the locker rooms, jump in the showers, and then change into our actual ROTC uniform, which for the AS-100s is the blues, either long sleeve or short sleeve depending on how cold it is. As soon as we're dressed, we meet back down in the gym, form into our flights, and conduct the opening ceremony. For AS-100s and 200s, Leadership Lab is basically the place where you learn all your drill and marching skills, you learn customs and courtesies of the Air Force, and many other skills. But most importantly, Leadership Lab's purpose is to develop you as an Air Force leader, whether that be participating in activities as an AS-100 or 200, or leading the AS-100s and 200s in their activities as a 300 or 400. Like PT, Leadership Lab is also cadet run. It's led by the AS-300s and 400s. An example Leadership Lab might be 45 minutes of marching and drill training. Then we might have a 30-minute GLP, which is a group leadership project, which kind of test our ability to lead and think on a moment's notice. Then we might finish up with a quick lesson on a specific Air Force skill like impromptu briefings. At the end of Leadership Lab, we all gather up at the end, we have announcements for the week, our commander talks to us for a little bit, and then we head to class. Basically, Leadership Lab is just the place where you learn all the Air Force skills that you can't be taught in the classroom. Speaking of classroom, as soon as Leadership Lab is done, all the AS-100s head over to another building where we have our classroom session. It starts at 9:30, it's only 50 minutes long, and it goes till 10:20. Also keep in mind, at this point, we're still in our ROTC uniforms, and we are required to be until 4 p.m. that day. Right now, my Air Force class is entitled Introduction to the Air Force Part 2, I guess. It's the same curriculum, just split into two different semesters. We've learned a lot of interesting stuff so far, but for the most part, the class kind of takes a look at the Air Force from a very broad perspective, as we talk about the Air Force's history and strategy on war and combat. But we also get a chance to learn some of the more specific skills that we need to become an Air Force officer, like dress and appearance standards and customs and courtesies. After class is finished on Thursday, I am done with my ROTC duties for the week, I guess. I still have to wear the uniform till 4 p.m. like I mentioned, but I don't have anything again till that next Tuesday, unless we have like a service project or MWR event over the weekend. I guess that's about it. Keep in mind that was just a brief overview of what ROTC life is like at Yale as a first year. If you have any questions about ROTC, Yale, me, or just want to say hi, make sure to leave them down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed the video, give it a nice big thumbs up. It helps a lot more than you think. If you're new and you haven't subscribed yet, you've been making a big mistake, and you should definitely do that as soon as possible. I will continue to post daily content as long as I possibly can. I am trying to balance schoolwork and everything with it, so we'll see how far that goes. Anyways, enough with me rambling. I'll be back soon with another video, so see ya.